So all of which what you just saw has been my routine every single day for the past 2 years. So it starts every day at 5 a.m. followed by writing, editing something, making breakfast, doing all that jazz, going to work, and then I come home on my lunch break to shoot these. So earlier this week, I posted a poll on Twitter to ask what you guys want me to make for my next video, because I was kind of scrambling and kind of going through this inner crisis of what I wanted to do next. For the most part, everyone was curious how I manage my job, having a YouTube channel, and my life. Really, the simplest answer that I have for how I do everything I've done over the past year or so is routine. So there's a time period in my life when I thought doing the same thing over and over again actually made you stupid. Looking back, that was just really ignorant Kurt just trying to be smart, but in actuality just making himself dumber. So I was under this impression that if you do the same thing every single day, then your mind's gonna get numb and you're gonna get stupid because you're not challenging your brain to develop in different ways. And in actuality, it's quite the opposite, or at least I found that it's the opposite. So my personal philosophy behind building a routine is to make the mundane, stupid shit in your life exactly what it's supposed to be, mundane. You shouldn't be challenging your brain and how you're gonna be brushing your teeth or what you're gonna be eating for breakfast or what time you're gonna be doing the dishes or how you're gonna do the dishes. Instead, those things should just become animalistic, almost like a habit. And in doing so, instead of focusing so much brain power on what hand you're gonna use when brushing your teeth, because you wanna be the two-handed, I forget the name of it, where you can use both your hands. So instead of using your brain power to figure out how you're gonna do the dishes differently or use your opposite hand to do them, you're instead making those things second nature, thus allowing your brain more room to think about things that are worth thinking about. Yeah, I think the best analogy is like driving a car. When you first learn how to drive a car, or maybe a bike in case you don't know how to drive a car or whatever, you're so concentrated on the mechanics of the vehicle and what pedal does what and being aware of your surroundings and how to, your brain is so focused in on absorbing information, on learning how to drive. So for most of us, once you learn how to drive, you just kind of zone out. That those things become second nature and leaves me all the room to think about melodies or songs or video ideas or big monsters destroying the city, in which most cases I kind of like come to and I don't actually know where I drove off to and I completely wasn't present. But along with creating a routine that makes the mundane almost second nature, you can apply the same idea to making shit, to creating things, to doing work. So for me, I work a day job. I work at a city newspaper and I write and do a lot of their social media for them. And of course, as we all know, having a day job can sort of feel like you're spinning your wheels when you're trying to pursue a bigger, more expansive dream. So sort of like getting up at the same time and showering at the same time and eating and doing the dishes at the same time, I also make it a priority that I have to create something at the same time every single day. So currently I wake up and immediately after taking care of the bathroom, skibbity bop, I then go and write. I don't know what I'm writing about. I usually have no idea what I'm writing about. Usually it's just me blabbering, saying I'm just waking up and I'm writing. From there, I usually start to edit what I had shot the day before on my lunch break. So in this case, what I'm shooting right now on my lunch break from work is gonna be what I'm editing tomorrow morning. And then what I'll do on my lunch break tomorrow is I'll come back home and I'll polish the video up, I'll upload it to YouTube, I'll create a thumbnail, do all that skibbity bop, rinse, repeat. It's all about creating habits. So after I'm done shooting this, I'm gonna go back to work and then I'm gonna pick up my girlfriend from work because we get out both at the same time. We come home, we have dinner, we spend mutual time together, and then like the rest of my life in a routinely fashion, I usually am in bed at the same time every single night. But also let me make this super duper clear. Having a routine and adapting to someone else's routine does not mean you'll amount to success in any way. And that isn't to say that I'm saying I'm successful. Success is a totally subjective thing and it's up to you to define what is success or not. For me, success is completely defined by simply doing things. If I'm able to finish this video and get it online by Friday at 8 a.m., then that is to me a success, regardless of whether or not I get any views, because for me, it's just about getting myself to do things, to create, to do stuff and not procrastinate, which is something that used to be a huge problem for me years and years ago. And, you know, and I think just consistency across the board is so vital and important for anything, especially for me as a YouTube creator dude. Even though someone may look at my subscriber base and be like, yo, you ain't that big of a deal, but to me, that 156 people is fucking mind-blowing, and it is confusing. Anyways, but I think a lot of that is owed to consistency and uploading at the same time every single week and giving your audience something to anticipate, something to expect. And in a way, you're building a routine for your audience. It's like a show that comes on every single week at a certain time. That audience expects it. They're gonna be waiting, they're seeing it. It's kind of the animalistic thing in all of us, you know, the creatures of habit, that's what we are. Anyways, we're actually approaching, it is about to be 1 o'clock, so I actually have to go get back to work, and I'll have to take care of this tomorrow. So I really hope in some way, shape, or form this added value or an idea of how I get what I get done, and hopefully there's something you can take from this. Oh wait, actually really quick, hold on. So really quick, two books that really helped me kind of define that and kind of narrow in on how I do what I do and continue to do what I do. So the first book I would suggest is Manage Your Day to Day by the 99U brand, whatever you want to call them, their website. This book has a lot of information that kind of was bloated nonsense to me, but there are these nuggets of gold that just spoke to me. And the whole idea is about building your routine, finding what works for you, and how you can apply that to your creative life. So I highly recommend this book. And then a good second one to read after that, and this is a very, very popular book. Most people have read this, I know, but is Steal Like an Artist by Austin Kleon. I read this book recently in my life, and though a lot of this I've learned by trial and error over the years of trying things desperately and failing and ripping off other artists and so on and so forth, but it's always good to have it on paper and kind of have someone else to relate to on the same wavelength. So I would highly suggest this to build your routine if that's something you want to explore, and this if you just need to be told, shut up and do shit. These are both great books. Okay, I gotta get back to work. Bye.